Thunder. Hot, cool is all you got. You know, in this day and age with record sales plummeting and skyrocketing gas prices making independently promoted tours prohibitively expensive, why would a group at your level even attempt to release an album and support it on the road?
You know, Chuck, that's a great question, but I just don't have the answer.
I guess it's just for the love of music then, huh?
Absolutely.
Now, you've all been good friends for quite some time, have lived together and worked together, and the whole thing just really reminds me of the classic television program Friends. I've been working it out, and assuming that you're the Chandler of the group, Sims, and POS, you're Joey, who would you both cast as Ross?
I'm not exactly sure what you're talking about.
Okay, POS. Brothers and sisters, I have none, but this man's father is my father's son. Who is this man?
I don't know.
Chuck? I lost contact with...
Music really can move people to action and can change.
This is fascinating, how we can see all these things happen thousands of years, millions of years, billions of years ago. And you stay with us and see it, because this is really interesting. I'm not going to move from this spot. We're going to go. I'll move.
Yep, and one last, yeah, okay. Now that we're done with our delightful little summer scene, it's time for the final step, the artist's signature.
Hey, yo, Turbo.
Here we go again. Yeah. All right.
Got hitting the bars tonight.
For the camera. Look at you guys. You got nothing.
I have a good time.
Oh, come on. We ain't that bad.
Sweet.
Yeah. Turbo. What up, dude?
Oh, shit.
Rumor is, although you are primarily a DJ and producer, you wrote most of the lyrics on the new Doomtree album.
Honestly, you couldn't be further from the truth.
Jesus Christ! Hey, Steve! Can you fix this? I'm sorry. Please continue.
Couldn't be further from the truth. I only wrote Mike's raps.
Most exciting trophy buck adventure ever produced.
Tear into a-
I don't know.
What a crapshoot.
I have no idea.
I'm gonna go. Here you go, alright. Okay. Dude, it was weird.
It was late to me. It was fine.
Yesterday we were in the studio laying down some stuff and you know, all day, and I didn't think to mention, I guess maybe I was a little self-conscious. I guess she probably was too, because it never came up.
I don't know why you would do this, and then I guess B, I don't know why you're wasting the film on asking me.
Yeah, I mean, from the get-go, it's just a very strange feeling to knock on the door of someone that you actually know and see quite often. And so that kind of set a bad tone.
I'm not gonna go on another date with Lazy. No, absolutely, he's lazy.
She did at the end, she said she had my number, so we'll see. You know, maybe I get a call back, or not to rule anything out ever, because, you know, weird things have happened, man.